नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम जेबिन डॉक्टर अजीज मोहित खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक कोलम क्रोमेटोग्राफी। दिस इज अ टेक्निक इन द सेपरेशन ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स ऑन द फेस ऑन कोलम क्रोमेटोग्राफी। इट इज अ टेक्निक फॉर प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स। वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द different stages of the particle, the Down syndrome stages, in which the first stage was the inorganic samples separation, and the next step was in the isolation of pure compounds. Third step was the purification of the pure compounds, purification of the molecules. And the last step for the polishing of the product. So the chromatography is used in the purification of the product. It is used in the purification step of the product. So in previous video, I discussed about the vapor chromatography and thin layer chromatography. And in this lecture, I am going to discuss about the column chromatography. So what is the column chromatography? In column chromatography, the molecules are separated and purified. It is mostly isolated. It is mostly used in the purification of the molecules. Okay, if we have isolated it, a particular kind of compound, a compound which have been isolated by plant extraction and some other techniques. So we can use this column chromatography for the isolation of a particular single type of compounds. Okay, and in Down syndrome processing, it is used in column. It is used in the separation of some proteins, liquids. Okay, it is used for isolation of particular single type of compounds. It is very effective technique. And very useful, and it is connected with thin layer chromatography. It is a technique which is directly connected with the column chromatography. So I'm going to discuss about the column chromatography, how the column chromatography is conducted. So in column chromatography, we use a column in a tube-like structure, which is known as a column. In that particular column, what we have inserted, the column which we are using is a tube-like structure on which at the bottom we have inserted a coating so that the solvent may not be disturbed and the evaporation may not be disturbed. Okay. And we also insert some stationary phase and our sample. Okay, so what are the stationary phase in the column chromatography? In the column chromatography, the stationary phase which is used on which our sample is loaded is silica gel. Okay, silica gel is used as a stationary phase, and sometimes alumina is also used. And this column chromatography is also used in the industry, and in industry silica gel is also used. If we talk about the mobile phase, so what is the mobile phase in the column chromatography? In mobile phase, we use a solvent according to the stationary phase. Whatever we are using, it will be dependent on the stationary phase, and some organic solvents are used. Some organic solvents such as and propanol, butanol, so these are used. The solvent which have been used in this column chromatography will depend on the polarity. From non-polar to polar. We are using, we can use the compound. For example, from hexane. Suppose we want to separate something. So we need methanol and hexane. We can use this type of solvents. So we can increase the concentration of these solvents. For example, if in the first two, in the starting, we can increase. In the starting, we can increase the concentration of the different solvents. Methanol is skipped. It will take all of the solvents. So the concentration of the methanol is lowered at the starting. And it is, and the column chromatography is a multi-step process, and it is used for the purification, which is not easy task. And for the purification, we need different combination of the solvent. Not a single type of solvent can perform all these. So suppose that we are using two solvents. One is polar and one is non-polar. Okay, so suppose at the starting we are using a 95, we are using 90% hexane and 10% methanol. Suppose that in the next two, so if we have used 10% methanol and 90% hexane, then the solvent will take the desired concentration of the molecules. Suppose we have not received the desired compound, desired product, then we can proceed from the next step. In the next step, we will increase the concentration of the methanol and decrease the concentration of the hexane. So in the next step, we will take only 85 ml of hexane, and then we will take 15 ml of the methanol, and then we will separate the particles in different tubes, 10 tubes. Okay, in 10 tubes. Suppose our particle which we want to purify is not received, then we will proceed it. How we check the particle is which we want to separate is found. I told at the starting that the column chromatography is directly related to the thin layer chromatography, because the particle which you want to separate is analyzed by the thin layer chromatography, and sometimes it is also analyzed by the mass molecular weight, by the analysis of the molecular weight of the compound. So in this technique, we are going to separate the particles on the basis of their polarity. So if suppose that in the second step it is not achieved, our product is not achieved, then we will go for the third step, in which we will increase the concentration of the methanol, which will be 20 ml, and the 80 ml of the hexane. If it is not still achieved, then we will take the next step, in which we will take 25 ml of methanol and 75 ml of hexane. Suppose that our result is gained in the 65 ml of the hexane and 35 ml of the methanol, then we will isolate our sample and check it by the thin layer chromatography. We will check it for the result that we have isolated. So we can collect our sample in tubes, and in that particular tube we can purify them. That will be standard for us. Okay. Standard method are designed by a particular individual. It can be designed by me, it can be designed by you. Okay. So it depends on the sample to sample. Okay. So this is the characteristic. What is the characteristic of the column chromatography? And the separation is conducted by the differential adsorption of the substance by the adsorbent of relative affinity. If the silica gel is relatively have relative affinity to a particular molecule, then it will be separated. What is the mechanism of separation? And the particles are separated on the basis of the retention factor, which we have studied in the thin layer chromatography in previous video. So higher the retention factor, the higher the product will have traveled. Okay, what is the advantage of the column chromatography? Column chromatography is low cost and the disposability of stationary phase is very possible, so less cross contamination is observed. But in the thin layer chromatography, the contamination was observed because it has not any relation, it has not any contact with the environment, so less contamination is observed. What is the disadvantage of the column chromatography? And the column chromatography is very, very time consuming, very time consuming. It will take one day to complete. Sometimes it may not be completed in a single day, and we can be disappointed. So it is very time consuming. That is very, very disadvantage. The next disadvantage, it is the separation power is very low. And but it is higher than the thin layer chromatography. The separation power is low but higher than the thin layer chromatography, paper chromatography. And the product are irreproducible, they are not properly. You can understand it by the diagram here. So I must share the screen here. So this is a diagram of the chromatography, column chromatography. So this is a column. Okay, in this column, and this is a very important thing where we have taken our sample. This is a column and it contains stationary phase, and in this stationary phase we have inserted our mobile phase. Okay, we have inserted our mobile phase and it is locked from both sides. Okay, at a particular point we will observe that our sample is inserted here. Okay, the sample is inserted here and it is loaded on the silica plate. Okay, it is loaded on the silica, so the sample will be separated on the basis of this different solvents, and they will be separated on this different tubes here, 1 tube, 2 tubes, 3 tubes. So different colors are observed. If we add different solvents in different time period, which I was discussing about 5 ml of methanol and 95 ml of acetone, so at different concentration of the solvent, different tubes are used. Okay, so when and different colors are observed. Suppose we want to collect this sample, so we will observe this sample. Okay, so this is the basic. So what are the layering of this column chromatography? In this column chromatography, first we insert a glass wool. Okay, first we insert a glass wool, then we insert our stationary phase, that is the silica gel. Then we insert some compounds which are mixed. Okay, not our solvent sample is not a pure sample. So and this is our sample here. Okay, this is silica. On this silica we have inserted our sample, and on this sample we add some solvents. So these are the solvents, okay, which will flow from here to here. Okay, the solvent will flow and it will take this solvent will travel from here to here, and it will separate our particles. It will separate our mixtures. It will separate our product, which will be separated in these different flask or different tubes. And different colors are observed in these tubes or a flask. If a desired product is achieved, then we will calculate the RF value of that particular compound, and our compound will be purified. So this is the normal procedure of the column chromatography. So I hope that students have better understood about the column chromatography. In this lecture, I discuss about the column chromatography, their stationary phase, their mobile phase, and what is their basic principle, what is their basic mechanism, how the samples are separated in the column chromatography, and how we can isolate our product. What are the advantages and what are the disadvantages of the column chromatography? So the question which can arise in according to this lecture is that explain column chromatography and their principle and their mechanism, how they will separate the particles. So I hope students will better answer all these questions. So my lecture is over here. Thank you very much. If you have any query, you can ask me. Thank you.